If you're a kid, this needle may be an object of dread for you. Sure, it does hurt a bit, but it is eventually a lifesaver. We've all had this needle prick us at some point of time in our lives, and I'm sure we've wondered what is injected inside us through this needle. We've also thought time and again about how this tiny injection of a medicinal fluid immunizes us, usually for our entire lives. Well, let's find out, shall we? The entire process of vaccine development and manufacture can be divided into 6 broad categories: exploratory stage, preclinical stage, clinical development. This itself has 3 phases, the ones about which we've been hearing a lot lately: regulatory review and approval, manufacturing, and quality control. Sounds quite cumbersome, right? But totally worth it to fight deadly diseases. Diseases such as typhoid, which is caused by the bacterium Salmonella typhi, is responsible for over 12 million new infections and more than 130,000 deaths each year, have been wreaking havoc. Similarly, the rotavirus causes diarrhea among infants and children throughout the world, causing over 450,000 deaths worldwide annually, inclusive of 200,000 infant deaths in India alone. Humanity has evolved a lot and has developed a myriad of vaccines, including the typhoid and the rotavirus vaccines. Some of these vaccines have had monumental effects on longevity of human life. These includes vaccine for diphtheria, tetanus, whooping cough, polio, measles, etc. The COVID-19 pandemic, caused by the severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2, had the world cowering for a while, infecting millions of people worldwide. But human spirit, alas, it is a truly wonderful thing. Arguably one of the greatest achievements by science for betterment of humanity, the vaccines developed against the COVID-19 virus are now being used in many countries across the globe. India has an indigenously developed vaccine for the same. India was swift to act. A strain of the novel coronavirus isolated by the National Institute of Virology, Pune, was handed over to Bharat Biotech in the month of May 2020. This collaboration of a private vaccine developer with eminent public institutes ICMR and NIV was instrumental in the development of this vaccine. The scientists, R&D teams, and manufacturing units worked round the clock, dealing with the deadly live virus, completing comprehensive preclinical studies. By the end of June 2020, Covaxin was evaluated in approximately 1,000 subjects in phase 1 and phase 2 clinical trials, with promising results. This basically means that it has pretty much eliminated escape mutants, such as the UK strain of the virus. It has also shown to generate memory T-cell responses, indicating longevity and a rapid antibody response to future infections. And it was then that India's first indigenous vaccine against COVID-19 was announced. Surely, you would have wondered how these life-saving shots have been developed. Come, dive with us straight into the process. First up is buffer preparation. Buffers are stabilizing compounds that are used to help a vaccine maintain its effectiveness during storage. Reagents are filled and mixed in stainless steel vessels at a preset temperature and are then filtered to keep only a pure mix of reagents in the buffer solution. The next step is media preparation. Nutrients, serum concentration, and other growth factors are added and mixed optimally to support proper growth in the cell culture. This mix is further transferred to the cell and virus culture lab, also known as the drug substance lab. In the drug substance lab, three different capacities of fixed bed reactors, virus harvest vessels, and media and buffer preparation vessels are available. In this specialized facility, whole virion coronavirus bulk is manufactured. And yes, virus cultures are handled under Biosafety Level 3 or BSL3, which is the latest and most secure biosafety facility in India. This is followed by virus cell stacks preparation in the same facility. So far, in a nutshell, the cells are first allowed to grow in an artificial media, and then the cultured cells are infected by the virus. Viruses then grow in these cultured cells. This is followed by a harvest of the virus for the manufacture of the vaccine.
The virus is inactivated.
Imagine all those people risking their lives in the presence of a live virus. The process of inactivation is carefully done. But even then, there is every chance of the people involved getting infected. And so that you know this as well, inactivation of the RNA of the virus is achieved by chemical treatment using a compound known as beta-propiolectone. Then, sterilization and purification take place. All unwanted components are filtered out. We then move on to the drug product lab. The lab has 300-liter fermenters, mixing vessels, vial washing machine, vial filling machine, and cap sealing machines. The product capacity of the drug substance lab is 750 grams, which is equivalent to 130 million doses per annum. And therefore, of course, this is the facility where Covaxin filling was carried out. More questions hovering in your mind, huh? Let us satiate your curiosity. speed of the vial filling machine was kept at 66 vials per minute, and the facility could handle 2 ml, 3, 5 and 10 ml vial formats. This is followed by quality control. This is done for each vial manually. Yes, yes, you're right. Every vial is double checked for quality. And then the vials are packed in boxes and are sent to a vehicle parked right outside the facility. The same temperature is maintained on the vehicle, which takes it to different places and subsequently close to your homes.